So how will you ensure that students with disabilities and their parents have the support they need during this time of disruption? And, you know, what do you say to those who warn that these cuts come at the great expense of students with disabilities?
Well, the layoffs are the result of the advice of our public health officer to close the schools. That a decision that was announced on March the 16th to close our schools to limit the spread of the coronavirus. Inevitably, that has meant that, a large number of people are no longer working in the school system. And so just as people have unfortunately been laid off from daycares to the service industry to probably hundreds of thousands of jobs, those positions in the schools have been affected, much like the municipalities in Alberta yesterday announced thousands of layoffs by employees affected by the public health orders, for example, library employees, recreational facility employees. So unfortunately, certain school board employees are affected in the same way. As you know, we continue to employ teachers to provide online instruction and continue to employ teaching assistants who support children in the PUF program, who are children with disabilities, children with special learning needs. So that support continues to exist for those kids, but we cannot pay to operate buses that are parked or to clean schools every day that are shut down, just as the cities can't pay folks to operate libraries that are shut down for the time being. This is very unfortunate. I don't, however, think it's reasonable to ask people in the private sector who have lost their jobs because of the public health orders to pay for salaries of folks in the public sector who have lost their jobs because of the public health orders. We're all in this together. The government is of both Canada and Alberta are providing extraordinary financial relief to people who have faced layoffs because of the coronavirus. That includes the emergency isolation payments from Alberta, the expanded employment insurance benefits from Canada, and hundreds of billions of dollars of fiscal support for Canadians as we get through this. The most important thing is we should point out is that when folks in the public sector who have been laid off because of the coronavirus, when we get in the post-pandemic period, their jobs will still be there. That cannot necessarily be said for a lot of people in the private sector. Today's announcement is about trying to create a broader economic future of economic and financial security for all of those being affected by this downturn.